Hey guys, this is Dayan
and I am Abhishek
and welcome to today's episode of GrowthX. In the last video, we spoke about what are the three key strengths you should look for in your growth lead. In today's episode, we want to talk about your data analyst, right? So this guy is one of the most important members of your team is because without data is just an
opinion.
Absolutely, right? So without this guy, your team is just going to be going blind, right? So the first thing that you should look for in your data guy is this guy should understand the product really well. And what we mean by that is understanding the customer journey itself, right? Right from the acquisition to retention and what the entire funnel itself, you should understand how the product is and how the consumer is consuming your product with that.
Right. Once he understands the basic product flows of the customer journey, the next important pointer that he will be able to figure out is what are the metrics that your team should look at daily, weekly, monthly, or whatever that frequency is.
Yeah.
Second, he will be able to look at what are the vanity metrics, right? And the third is what are the input and output metrics, right? Like, a lot of team members will be looking at output metrics, but he should be the person who should help out what are the input metrics.
Yeah.
The most important with data analyst is he should be able to make everybody self-sufficient of data.
Independent.
Right? And so basically he should automate a lot of data requests that are coming in and make dashboards which the team should look at whatever frequency, daily, weekly or monthly is.
Right?
Once this is done, then the next important parameter comes in.
And only if this is done, then he can actually spend his time focusing on the microscopic data values that are flowing through his system, right? This is basically conversion rate optimization. Your data guy should be extremely emotional when it comes to CRO, right? Because he's going to be the person who's going to look at a microscopic level for all the data points, right? Because without that, it's just, not taking any advantage of the data that he's looking at or is able to understand.
Right. And once he figures out the CRO bit, the next, in a larger picture, right, he should be the person who gets insights to the growth lead, right? Imagine growth lead having 10-20 experiments set up for, say, for a month, right? This guy should not go back and ask growth lead that which data you want.
Yeah.
This guy should automatically figure out what data framework he will need. And the conversation with this guy and the growth lead or any consumer for that fact should be about what are the next steps,
right?
You know,
whether it's the UX guy who's consuming the data or it's the
product person. So the conversation would be more about understanding insights. So I think we are slightly shifting on what the focus of this guy is. This guy is not just who understands SQL or certain set of tools. That can be a topic for another vlog at what tools he should know, how he should know join tables, or how he should know data engineering, right? His more value add is going to be which metric is moving in which direction and what are the basic hypotheses behind that.
Because that's a burning issue.
Right. And he should be the person who is on top of that issue. Yeah. Because once he's on top of that issues, nobody has to look for which data to look for.
Yeah.
Everybody's thinking about possible solutions.
Yes.
And that will really help to, go ahead and iterate faster. Because that's the only point of having this team.
Absolutely.
Right.
Yeah.
I think we have covered a lot of pointers on data, data analyst part. We would love to understand from our network who are currently our data analyst, machine learning people, how does their experience varies in group teams? How much value are they able to add to their teams, or is it just a data pull job? I would love to understand more from the ecosystem here.
Awesome. Until next time, guys. See ya.